During our most recent adventure together, I had the opportunity to try the new Play Disney Parks app at Walt Disney World. I tried the Agent P adventure, I tried the Neverland adventure, and I was playing online for Slinky Dog and a few other places. I was listening to Disney music as I was walking around. So in today's video, I'm going to share with you some of my thoughts about some of the really great things about the app and some things that could use some improvement. As a very quick overview, the Disney Play Parks app is available for Android and iPhone, and you can play at Walt Disney World and Disneyland. Today, I'm talking about Disney World. The purpose of the Disney Play Parks app is to give you something to do while you're waiting in line. You can play a game, you can play trivia, or you can just play Disney music while you're standing there waiting for your next attraction. Most of the games are pretty queue line specific. I actually tried playing the Neverland game from Peter Pan's queue outside of the queue. I just tried waiting in line for Cinderella's Royal Carriage. Sure enough, I couldn't do it because I couldn't see the things in the queue that I had to answer questions about or had to ask other people questions about. So sure enough, they only really work well while you're standing in the queue for that line. The app is available to download anywhere. You don't have to be at Walt Disney World to download it, and you can play the music and trivia from anywhere. You do not have to be in the parks to play the music or play the trivia games. It is a lot of fun. If you're missing Disney a lot, you want to play some of that music, which is my favorite, or play trivia. It's a great game to have on your phone just to pass the time. Along with the music and the trivia, Disney also has these really cool achievements that you can earn by going on certain rides at Walt Disney World. For example, I got this for going on Buzz Lightyear's Space Ranger Spin, the Zurg Zapper achievement. It's a fun thing to get, and Disney gives you this little button right there so you can share your achievement with friends on Facebook, Twitter, or just as a message. Look at that Elf and Dwarf, Seven Dwarfs Mine Train. That's pretty cool. Look at that Splash Mountain one. That's another great one. Now, along with all of those things, one of the highlights of the Play Disney Parks app are those different games that you can play in line. And before we talk about the ones that you can play in line, let's talk about the game that you can play around World Showcase, Agent P's Adventure. Agent P's World Showcase Adventure has been around for a little while. We used to have to go to this kiosk right before you enter World Showcase, coming from Future World to World Showcase. You'd go on your phone, they'd set up everything, and you'd go around and have an adventure. Now that game has moved to the Play Disney Parks app, and I tried it many different times on our adventure. Waiting for it to load. It's a lot of fun. Problem is, you keep running into these errors where you can't connect. I'm gonna try connecting to the Wi-Fi again, see if that solves the problem. I'm sad it's just sitting here stalled. I was so close to finishing the Japan mission. Overall, I think it's really cool how you can push a button on your phone and interact with the parks in a special way. If I had to guess, I would imagine Disney will implement even more of this in the future. My mind immediately goes to Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. We'll have to see. Despite all of my different attempts all around World Showcase to try and play the Agent P adventure, Doofenshmirtz got the best of me, and I wasn't able to play because of a connection issue. I have a feeling Disney is already aware of this and probably working on a fix right now. If they haven't already fixed it by the time this video comes out, I'm sure they're going to make it perfect for our next adventure together in September. And look at those animations on there. You can see Perry hiding right there. Oh, he's in Japan too. Look at that. He's hiding all over the place. Being able to interact with real life things, have things change just by pressing a button on your phone is so cool. I'm looking forward to it working in full on our next adventure together. Along with Agent P's World Showcase Adventure, there are a plethora of other games all around Walt Disney World at some of the most popular attractions. For example, I had the opportunity to try Andy's Board Game Blast online for Slinky Dog Dash. This game was really interesting. You had the opportunity to pick a player and then start on the game board and play different mini games to advance further in the game. It was a lot of fun. Also in Toy Story Land, while you're waiting in line for Toy Story Midway Mania, is the Playset Party, where you have the opportunity to assemble different toys in the toy box. A lot of fun. Now, several of the games are these mini game style, where you're playing a board game or you're assembling characters, but there are also others that are kind of like trivia and different questions for a larger group. For example, when you're in line for Peter Pan's flight, you could ask a question of a group. Which would you rather do, fly with pixie dust or sail on a pirate ship? Let's say fly with pixie dust. You turn the page and then things change. When you enter this room, things can change around you. You look for Tinkerbell, you answer different questions. There are a lot of things to interact with as you're walking around. In this game, Off to Neverland, you also have the opportunity to select which trinkets belong to Tinkerbell, just as an example. So you're standing in line, you're able to see these things come to life in line, and then you select collect the things in the game and you get to interact even more. Also in the Off to Neverland game, you have the opportunity to hear what other people said about the same question. For example, you say, who are you most like? Peter Pan, Tinker Bell, or Wendy, just as an example. Maybe 29% of people said Peter Pan and 38% of people said like Wendy. As an example, you can interact with other guests without knowing who they are, but everyone votes together. In the game, you also have the opportunity to tell stories. There are jokes in the game and the opportunity to draw different things to share with friends. Now, the Play Disney Parks app was released just before our adventure together, so keep in mind Disney is probably going to update this very soon with an update, probably some more games, fix that problem with Agent P so in the future it'll work perfectly. But what are my initial thoughts about the game? So overall, I think it's a really good thing. I think many guests are going to enjoy it, especially families traveling together. I have no doubt they will enjoy it in the parks. But that being said, I also want to mention how I feel as a Disney enthusiast. Like, I kind of want to pay attention to something other than my phone when I'm at Walt Disney World. When I go to Walt Disney World, I like to be whisked away to a place where dreams come true and fantasies are real. And when I look at my phone, I feel like this is a big dose of reality. I don't like to look at this too much when I'm at Walt Disney World. I talk all about how I like to disconnect more at Disney. And do I feel like this is reconnecting a little bit more at Disney? Yes, a little bit. Do you remember not too long ago on Space Mountain when they had this game, kind of like Asteroid, where you have two controls and one shoot button and you'd play a game with a lot of different people in line with you? To me, that is a really cool way to interact in a queue line with other guests around you. Now, I do understand that the Play Disney Parks app is meant to take this idea and put it on your phone so that everyone can interact with the game while they're standing in line throughout the entire line. In my example on Space Mountain, that game was only for a short period of the standby line, and then you would wait in more of the line where the game wasn't right there. So on one hand, I really do think that the Play Disney Parks app is a great opportunity for you to be able to experience more of the magic and pass the time a little bit while you're waiting in the queue line. For me, I'm probably going to be taking a lot of pictures, but I am going to be playing once in a while just to experience the magic. But one of my favorites, and it probably will remain one of my favorites for a while, is the Agent P World Showcase Adventure, because something in Walt Disney World changes when I push a button on my phone.
I heard an explosion. I see Doofenshmirtz kind of burned there.
The water just came on after I clicked OK.
If Disney is able to take that same Agent P adventure and interact with something in the real world after touching something on your phone in more of the queues, I think this could be a huge success. And taking it a step further, Disney could also make it more interactive with other guests. For example, let's say you have a profile and you're battling the evil Emperor Zurg in line for Buzz Lightyear Space Ranger Spin. And when you're standing there, other guests have the opportunity to battle him too. And when you battle together, you get a different achievement and everyone can work together. They can really expand upon this idea to make it even more interactive. So in conclusion, I am looking forward to seeing more improvements to the Play Disney Parks app in the future, and I sure hope that Disney implements it in some way to interact with the real world along with your phone. Now, you've had the opportunity to see me experience it just a little bit in the vlog. What did you think? And maybe you've already had the opportunity to play the game a little bit. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. And do you think Disney will continue to expand upon this and hopefully make it even more interactive with things you see in the real world at Walt Disney World? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Thank you so much for being a part of the magic with me. Until next time, have a magical day.